says exercise 6.2 from your textbook, homework problems. The first one is question 25. It says a cone-shaped candle looks like this, whose height, so the height, there's your height and radius, but we know that the height is 3 times the radius. Now, it's melting at a constant rate. Now, you'll know the units by looking at the units of this. What are the units of centimeters cubed per second? What are the volume? So that, see that 1.4 centimeters cubed per second is d what dt? dv/dt. How do you know? You look at the units. Centimeters cubed per second means volume with respect to time. So it's, so the rate of change of volume, sorry, is 1.4 centimeters cubed per second. So dv/dt is 1.4 centimeters cubed per second. It says if the proportion of radius to height is preserved, in other words, the height is always 3 times the radius, okay? Find the rate at which the radius will be decreasing. So you want dr/dt. So this is what you're being asked, to find dr/dt when what? When what is 3.7? Find the rate at which the radius will be decreasing when r is 3.7. So we've only got volume, rate. We're not being asked about surface area, so I don't think you're going to have one where you've got three lots of multiplying. It's only with two. Now, we're looking for dr/dt. Now, let's just come up with a formula. Because we're working with volume, what does the volume equal? What's the formula for volume? A third area of the base, which is pi r squared times h. So it's a third pi r squared times, what's h? Good. The three and the third cancel. So you get that the volume is pi r cubed. It's, yeah, because it's 3 pi r cubed on 3, which is pi r cubed. So you can now work out dr is 3 pi r squared. So that's what we've got to work with. So let's start. So we have to find dr/dt. So dr/dt equals, wouldn't it be dr/d, all right, what, it has to be dr/dv. So it's dr/dv times, well, I need to get, I need, times dv/dt. Now over here, I've got dv/dr is that, so therefore dr/dv is what? 1 over 3 pi r squared. And now let's just substitute. Yes, because it's decreasing. Thank you. So it's a negative 1.4. Very good. So that's a negative up there. So now dr/dv is 1 over 3 pi r squared times negative 1.4. And we substitute r is 3.7. And then you can work out the rest. Oh. Okay. What did you get? It's small, whatever it is. Oh, very small. Negative 0.01 centimeters, because it's change of radius. With respect to time, it'll be centimeters seconds to the minus one, or centimeters slash seconds per second. Okay. Question 20. The formula for the acceleration of a particle is given by a is 5x minus e to the 2x plus 3, where x is the displacement of the particle. Now, the acceleration is at a constant rate of negative 9.8. meters per second, or meters second to the minus two, because girls please, because displacement is x, velocity is dx/dt, which is meters per second, But acceleration is dv dt, so it's your meters per second divided by seconds again. So acceleration is, you can write it as dv dt, or you can write it as, oh, anyway, we'll just see. I think I can see what your problem is. All right. So acceleration is at the constant rate, or do we just call that da dt? No, it's not. Acceleration is dv dt, or it's d squared x by dt squared. X is x, it's displacement, isn't it? Velocity is dx dt. So the units of x, for example, in this case, would be meters. The units of velocity are meters divided by seconds, which is meters per second, right? And the units of acceleration, now acceleration is dv dt. So it's this one. It's this divided by time, which is ms to the minus one, or you can write it as d squared x by dt squared. Ms minus, thank you. Ms minus two. Okay, so it's these units divided by time again, ms minus two. Okay, meters per second per second. So you cannot write dA dt. It doesn't make sense. The only thing you can write for acceleration would be d squared x by dt squared or dv dt. Now, rate of, girls, now, they're also asking, so girls, see this thing? Let's just do dA dx while we're here. Can we do that? Let's just do dA dx while we're there. What have we got? Five minus. Well, you write it out again and then you differentiate. So you get 2e to the 2x. That's what dA dx is. Now, we've been given that a is equal to negative 9.8 meters per second, but a happens to be b dt. You can't go changing that. That's what a is. It's dv dt, or it's d squared x by dt squared, but we can't use that. So we're going to use dv dt, which is negative 9.8 meters per second. So that's what we've done so far. We've been given this, we've differentiated. Acceleration, looking at this, x is just x, v is dx dt, and a is dv dt. That never changes. All right? Now, see this last sentence? Find the rate of change of displacement. Tell me which of these is the rate of change of displacement. They're just saying find the velocity. So the rate of change of displacement, this is what they're asking you to do. They're asking you to find the velocity when the displacement's negative 0.3, or because it's a rate question, the rate of change of displacement. So they're asking you to find dx dt when x is negative 0.3, when the displacement, which means x, is negative 0.03. So I can see your little problem here. They're asking you to find dx dt. And if we just do what we've normally been doing, it's dx dA times, why don't I go dA dx, which I can't. So the only way you can sort of get this to work is going dA dt. Now, when it says the acceleration is at a constant rate, dA dt means the rate of change of acceleration. That's what that means. And that rate of change of acceleration is zero. So I believe that there is a problem with this question, that acceleration is always dV dt. That never changes. But if we want to use this, you have to put zero here and it's just going to wipe everything out. So I think that this is worded incorrectly, or some, well, it's not worded incorrectly. It just means that this particle is falling with got gravity acting on it. But I have a problem writing that dA dt is negative 9.8. That is not the rate of change of acceleration. The rate of change of acceleration is zero because it's constant acceleration. So I'm not putting negative 9.8 there, even though that does work out for you. And it wipes the whole thing out. dA dt is zero. I'm not sure what's going on with this question. I'll have to have a look at it and come back to it. So the volume of water in a tidal pool is given as V equals 2 cos 3 pi on x. I don't like that x being on the bottom there. Where x is the depth of the water in the pool. Okay, the volume of water in a tidal pool. Think of Wet n Wild, the wave pool or something. All right? It's a tidal pool. So the water goes up, the water comes down. The water goes up, the water goes down. Okay, and cos curve, actually, girls, it would start like this, really. Do you know what I mean? The darker one starts there. Okay, where x is the depth of water in the pool. And doesn't mean that the axis is down. It might not be in the middle, I'm not sure. Find the rate at which the depth of the pool will be increasing when the volume of the pool is increasing at that rate. So, find the rate at which the depth of the pool will be increasing. What are they asking you to find? What are they asking? Find dx dt when what? When dv dt equals 12 meters cubed per hour and the depth, what's that? And x is 1.2 meters. Okay. Okay, we've got that V equals 2 cos 3 pi on x, which is 2 cos. Guys, we don't may just sorting out that query. You can differentiate any cos function. So if it's y equals cos function of x, then dy dx is the negative derivative of that function times sine function of x, but where you can only integrate is it has to be in the form of cos ax plus b. It's different. You can't just integrate any cos function or any sine function. The only ones that we know how to integrate are cos ax plus b or sine ax plus b, etc. So we can differentiate any cos function. Just clarifying that for me as well. Okay, all right, so that's cos 3 pi x to the minus 1. So therefore, dv dx is, what do you get? You get a negative for a start. So you get negative, negative. Okay, so let's differentiate that first, and you keep the 2, and you get negative 2 sine 3 pi on x times. So if you just differentiate that, you get the negative 2 sine 3 pi x to the minus 1, but then we need to times it by the derivative of this, and we get negative 3 pi x to the minus 2. So this becomes negative 2 sine 3 pi on x. Oh yeah, we may as well. Negative times negative is positive 6. All right, I'll write it again. It's 6 pi over x squared. 6 pi over x squared sine 3 pi over x. So that's what dv dx is. Now, I think, does this just work out nicely now? Do we know what to do? So now we've got, you have to find dx dt. So dx dt will be dxd. Come on, what do you have to put? It's got to be dx dv times dv dt. What do you mean? That is negative 2 times negative 3 is 6, the pi, x to the minus 2. This, because negative 2 times negative 3 is 6, there's the pi, x to the minus 2 is over x squared. You don't times this 3 pi x by that. That's a whole number, that's a coefficient of all of that. Because it's the derivative times, sorry, why don't you times that by that? That doesn't belong with the angle. It's like, look, it's like doing this. If I ask you to differentiate y equals cos 2x, how do you do that? How do you do that?
Times
the derivative of 2x, which is 2, and that doesn't become negative sine 4x, it becomes negative 2 sine 2x. It is here. Not that. Did I lose my formula sheet? Here. Differentiate it and you get negative sine fx, and but the f dashed x goes in front. So,
okay, I'll try again.
So which is? Girls, you need to be working in radians modes when you've got linear quantities with angle sort of quantities. So dx dv is the reciprocal of this, which is x squared over 6 pi. What's 1? So guys, be careful. How do you flip that? You get x squared on 6 pi. What's 1 over sine? I can just do it. I can just put the sine down here. No, I'll just put it down there. All right, so this is what I've got. That's my numerator. Can you see that? That's my numerator. That's my denominator. So now when I do the reciprocal, that's my numerator. That's my denominator. Yeah, we'll do it in a minute. Times 12. So at the moment, this is all the numerator. The x squared's the denominator. When you do the reciprocal, you get x squared over that. Now we sub x is 1.2, okay? So we sub x is 1.2. Make sure you're in radians, please. So you get 1.2 squared over 6 pi sine of 3 pi over 1.2 times 12. Make sure you're in radians mode. Radians. I'd be doing 1.2 squared times 12, press equals on my calculator, divided by bracket 6 pi sine, and then I'd go bracket here, I'd go bracket
the
there.
Whole
yes, the whole thing. So that 1.2 squared times 12, I'd get an answer for that, press equals, and then divide by open bracket 6 pi sine, open bracket, 3 pi over 1.2, close bracket. And then you get? Because you're doing, you got pi, sine of pi.
So every time it's pi, radians.
Yes, it's radians. If you want to work in degrees, you'd have to put that as 180 degrees. You'd have to go sine 3 times 180 divided by 1.2 if you want to be in degrees. You never use pi in degrees mode. It's in radians mode. What do you get?
0.916.
What are the units? All right, what are the units? Okay. It says 23 on my thing, but it's the old. So question 33. I'll see if I can find that. It says a kite that is 20 meters high, so the kite is up here, is blown along horizontally at 3 meters per second. So you don't put 3 meters per second on this diagram. This diagram is about distances and distances only. You don't get putting speeds on the diagram, just distances. 20 meters high, the speed is at 3 meters per second, it's being blown by the wind. What is the rate of the string being let out when it is 40 meters long? So they've told us that it's blown along at 3 meters per second. If you look at the units of meters per second, isn't that velocity? Dx, isn't it change in x with time? And that's the change, it's being blown horizontally. So I've got my diagram as 20 meters up, horizontal distance is x. So therefore, because I've defined x as my horizontal distance and it's being blown horizontally at that speed, that means that the rate of change of x with time is 3 meters per second. Next thing, we've got this diagram. I've called that x. This here is 20 meters, and I'm going to call this y. So you can come up with an expression for y in terms of x. So therefore, we know that y squared is x squared plus 20 squared. which means that y is the square root of, so then we come down here, y is the square root of x squared plus 20 squared. In other words, y is x squared plus 400 to the power of a half. Sorry? Because I'm differentiating dy dx. All right, I haven't got to that yet. I'm just setting up what I think I need to set up first. So I came up with an expression for y in terms of x here, and just naturally from that, I've just done dy dx. We're going to look at the rate in a minute. I suppose you should write out your rate thing first, but until you finish this diagram and define that as x and this as y, see, y is the length of the string. See, if the person standing here and the kite this is... All right, but that's at that particular time. That's not always. The string isn't always 40 because it's moving across here at 3 meters a second. It's all right. They want to know at what rate is the string being let out. So they're asking about this. See, now this will keep getting bigger, that y, as the kite moves across. So we've just worked out dy dx, but that's got nothing to do with the rate that we need yet. So, so now that we've got that diagram, I'll do it again down here, 20, x, and y. They're asking for the rate at which that is being let out. So that would be dy dt. It has to be dy dx times, we've got dx dt already from the top. Because it's the rate at which the string... Just imagine if you've got a kite on a string. So the kite is 20 meters high, so that distance is 20 meters high. The kite's here, but then the kite's going to move, sorry, the kite's going to move there, the kite's going to move there, the kite's going to move there. And can you see how the length of the string holding the kite will change? It's on a reel, and it can change that length of the string.
So why is the length?
Why is the length of the string? So they're asking for the rate, at what rate is the string being let out? So they want, so y will change. So they want dy dt. So what we want is, why don't I write it here? They want us to find dy dt when y is 40. That's what they want us to find. Dy dt when y is 40. Yes. So the problem is, you don't have a formula for y. So I've done that up there. Got to come back up. So here. So we go dy dt is dy dx times dx dt. Dy dt, this is what dy dx is, times 3. But the problem is I don't have a substitution for x. So what I do, I come back to my triangle, I'm interested when y is 40, and I work out the length of x at that time. So when y is 40 at that instant in time, x is square root of 40 squared minus 20 squared. That's 20 squared. Do you want me to write 20 squared? I'll write 20 squared. Square root of 40 squared minus 20 squared, which is the square root of 1200. So therefore, dy dt is square root of 1200 over square root of 1200 plus 400, which is the square root of 1600. Do you want to write it here? Yeah, I'll write it as, or is that okay? 1200 plus 400. Oh, you can't read that now. 1200 plus 400, which is square root of 1200 over the square root of 1600 times 3. All right, I'll fix that up. Yeah. All right. That's 1200 plus 400. Because it's from the formula. X over x squared plus 400. All right. X over x squared would be square root of 1200 squared plus 400. There you go. So I'm just substituting into this. I know what x is. It's the square root of 1200. So I'm just substituting into that. So it's the square root of 1200 over the square root of the square root of 1200 squared plus 400, which happens to be 1200 plus 400. So it's the square root of 1600. Okay. What don't you get?
Why do you put on the square root of?
Because it's the square root. Look at the formula. It's the square root of x squared. Now, you know what? If x is square root of 1200, what's x squared? 1200.
Yeah.
So it's the square root of x squared. X squared is the square root of 1200 squared.
Oh, yeah, okay.
So I had just written 1200 there in the first place because that's what x squared was. Do you want me to just write 1200 there now? Now that we've got x squared there?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Do you get that now? She's like a funnel, drops sand at a constant rate of 8 meters cubed per minute. So this 8 meters cubed per minute is what? D what? D what? Look at the units. It's a volume and time. It's dV dt. Okay. As the sand forms to the ground, so we've got the funnel, sand's coming out. As the sand forms to the ground, it forms a cone shape. It looks like that. Okay, so the sand will fall in the shape of a cone, such that the height of the cone, so we know cone looks like this, height and radius, such that the height of the cone is 2 times the radius. It says find the rate at which the height of the sand will be changing. I can see why you've got a bit of a problem here, because it's dHdt or d2rdt. Now, we're not going to write d2rdt. We're going to do dHdt, all right? So we want to find, they're asking us to find dHdt when what? When height is 2 meters. Yeah, it's when 2r equals 2, but I'm not going to do drdt. I'm not doing, actually, if I work out drdt, no. Because do we know, oh yeah, but the height is all, look, we find the rate at which the height of the sand will be changing. Because the height is always twice the radius, if we work out drdt for the radius, the height will be changing at double that rate. So we'll just, if we actually find drdt and then times the answer by 2, we can do it like that. All right, if we try the dHdt and we get stuck, we're going to do drdt, get that, and times the answer by 2 at the end because the radius is always double the height. I mean, the height's always double the radius. So what should we do next? We're going to need a volume somewhere. Volume is. Why do we need a volume? Because we've got dv dt. So we need to be cancelling that v with something. What's the volume of this cone? 1/3. I know what we can do. I know what we can do. You can write the volume in terms of h instead of r. So volume is 1/3 pi r squared times h, isn't it? Well, we've got a problem in that. All right, everyone wants to make this 2r. Why don't we make the r h on 2? And then we can do dv dh, and then we've got no problems. All right? So let's go v is 1/3 pi times. If h is 2r, therefore r is h on 2. So it's because we need dv dh. I don't want dv dr. I want dv dh because I'm trying to find dh dt. You'll see, if I want dh dt, isn't that going to be dh dv times dv dt? That's the, see, because I've got dv dt, I need a v down here, a dv there. So problem is, everyone wants to write volume is 1/3 pi r squared times height and then put it all in terms of r. But if you decide to not put it in terms of r and leave it instead, we've got two options here, make everything in terms of r or everything in terms of h. If we make it all in terms of h, we've fixed our problem up. So it's 1/3 pi, r is h on 2, so it's h squared on 4. Are we okay with that? Times h. Because r squared is h squared on 4. So therefore, v is pi h cubed on 12. So therefore dv dh is, we got it, 3 pi h squared on 12. Do you know what I'm doing? Do you know why I did it?
Yeah.
Which is pi h squared on 4. Now we're going to keep it in terms of r and try and double it at the end to see if it works as well. Now we can substitute in and do what we need to do. So dh dv is the reciprocal of that, which is 4 over pi h squared. And dh dt, no it's not, dv dt is 8. We now substitute, h is 2. So we go 4 over pi times 2 squared times 8. Or sub. Don't they cancel? You get 8 over pi, which is about 2 point something. 2 decimal places. 2.55. Rate of change of height will be meters per minute. Okay. Now, let's go with the other method. Can we do dvdr? But you can't, that means you only find dr dt. I think this is better. If you want to do the other method and make this in terms of r, you can only find dr dt. So let's say you couldn't think of that, but you will think of that next time because we've just done it. But let's try, the only other way you could do it is work out dr dt, but I'm not sure. If we do dr dt and just work that out times the answer by 2, as long as the radius is expanding in proportion to the height, it would work. All right, so I'm going to do, all right, so there's another method. I'm thinking we're going to find, instead of finding dv dt, dh dt, we're going to find dr dt instead. And then times the answer by 2. Let's try that. Dr dt is dr dv times dv dt. So volume is a third pi r squared times h, which is a third pi r squared times 2r, which is part 2 pi r cubed on 3. This is the other way of doing it. You'd never be able to work out dh dt this way. You can only work out dr dt. Does that make sense? Which is 3 times 2 pi r squared on 3, that's dv dr, which is 3's cancelled, 2 pi r squared. So dr dt is dr dv, which is the reciprocal of this, times dv dt is 8. So we've got 4 over pi times, what's r? When h is 2 will be when r is 1. See, this method presents so many problems, this second method. Do you understand?
Yeah.
You've got to do it the first way. But if you want dr dt when h is 2, it's the same as saying when r is 1. I'm just seeing if we get the same answer. It doesn't work. It doesn't work. You know why it doesn't work? Because maybe it's r squared. Well, no, they've told us.
No, but they told us that.
What have I done? Have I done anything wrong here? Oh, I know what the problem is here. Oh, no, it's not. Guys, can you see what I've done wrong? Oh, this is the problem. No 8. No 8. 4 over pi, and then I times it by 2. It's the same. So it's 4 over pi, and then I go, therefore, dh dt is 4 over pi times 2, which is 8 on pi, which is the same. I didn't see this. 8 on 2 is 4. I left the 8 there. That's 8 on 2, which is 4. Wait, I can't not give you homework this week.